Hi guys, Dr. Cliff Olson live again from AAA 2018 on behalf of Hearing Tracker. And right now I have Drew Dundas, who's actually the, get this, he's the Senior Director of Audiologic Technology and Innovation for Earlens. So that's a mouthful, but you've earned that title, so we're going to make sure that we say it. I've had a chance to actually work with Earlens a bit, and very, very cool technology. So explain, what really is Earlens?
Well, Earlens is probably the most significant advancement in hearing technology in the last 20 years. It's a system that is very similar to traditional hearing aids in many ways, but very different in others, using an actual lens similar to a contact lens that sits on the eardrum to transduce sound. And this offers a greatly enhanced sound quality experience for the user of the technology.
So when we talk about enhancing our ability to, you know, improve sound for them, what does that really mean? Like, what are we achieving with this that we aren't getting actually from traditional hearing aids?
Well, traditional hearing aids are very limited in the frequency bandwidth, or sort of the pitches that are able to be transduced through the hearing device. You can think of this like the pitches as being like a piano keyboard. And a traditional hearing aid might only be able to provide a useful audibility of sounds across a small portion of that keyboard. The Earlens system, on the other hand, is able to represent almost three times as many frequencies as a traditional hearing aid, making a much more natural listening experience for
right.
the user.
Right, so, you know, the tagline is kind of like, hear the light, right? And so when we start talking about using light to trigger sound, what's the process of that? Because that doesn't make a lot of sense to a lot of people, I think.
Yeah, it's a great question. One of the reasons why traditional hearing aids can't reproduce those sounds is because of the difficulty of getting those sounds through the eardrum and into the inner ear. And the Earlens system makes use of an actual laser beam to send information from the processor, which is worn behind the ear like a more traditional hearing aid, into the ear down to that lens, which is then both powered by the laser as well as receiving the information for the signal from that laser itself.
Right. So I think a lot of people associate this idea of a lens with a contact lens, right? And essentially, it's almost like a contact lens for your eardrum.
I think that's a good way to think about it. It's actually held in place on the eardrum through a combination of the custom design of the lens and the surface tension that's created between the custom platform and the ear canal. But really, only one tiny portion, about 3 millimeters or 3/32 of an inch in diameter, actually makes contact with the eardrum. So it's very comfortable to wear, and you're not really aware of it being there. And the placement process isn't a surgery either. It's just placed by a physician in the office and resides long-term on the eardrum.
So it begs the question, if we're talking about a custom lens that's going on the eardrum, what's the process of actually getting it to be custom? Because, I mean, your eardrum's pretty far inside there in a delicate area.
It is indeed. An ENT physician or an otologist actually performs an impression of the entire ear canal, down to and including the surface of the eardrum. And this is a process that feels a little odd because most people have never had their eardrum touched, certainly not on purpose.
Right.
But it is not uncomfortable to any significant extent. It's just kind of a weird feeling. It takes about 10 minutes per ear in the office to perform that procedure.
So how are you building these lenses?
We have really only been able to do this over the last few years because of the incredible advances that have occurred in 3D printing technology. So once we've obtained that impression, we digitally scan it using a high-resolution laser scanner and then build everything digitally with very careful design rules, then build the actual platforms using high-resolution 3D printing technology.
So I think that there might be people out there who are skeptical of whether or not maybe their type of hearing loss is right for Earlens. They might think of it as like, oh, well, that's for someone who has way worse hearing than I do. That's probably not for me. Is that real?
Well, actually, the technology is appropriate for people with hearing difficulties from the mild range all the way up to the moderately severe range. So it really is appropriate for 80 to 90% of the hearing
impaired
population.
Right, so a large population of people are actually candidates for this technology, despite if they only have even a mild to moderate hearing loss.
Absolutely, right? And those are some of the people who have some of the best outcomes as well, because they're typically the patients who are most sensitive to the improvements in sound quality that can result from that broader frequency response and the direct drive mechanism.
Right. So direct drive. So when this light comes in, so you have an ear mold inside of your ear, pretty deep inside of your ear.
Yeah.
It has a tip on it that flashes an infrared light. Am I correct
That's
with that?
That's right. Yeah.
And that light will hit what I like to call a solar panel.
That's a great description
on the lens,
of that.
Right? And that's what actually activates the driver to thump the eardrum.
Exactly.
Right?
So the photo detector is exactly a small solar panel. It generates an electrical voltage, very low voltage, that's converted into a magnetic field in a tiny motor, which then directly activates the umbo at the center of the eardrum. And this movement is really very, very tiny, and it's imperceptible from a physical standpoint. The smallest movements that we make are smaller than the diameter of a hydrogen atom, and the largest
pretty small.
And the largest movements that we make are about 1/5 the diameter of a human hair.
Okay.
So it's really not perceptible from a physical standpoint, but the listening experience is pretty extraordinary.
That's terrific. So now let's talk about the process of getting one, right? So you're still going to go in to your audiologist or your hearing care professional. You're going to get a traditional hearing test, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which we then use for candidacy.
That's
but
right.
You're also going to end up seeing an ENT or an otologist in order to be evaluated to see if this is right for them, correct?
That's right. Currently, the delivery model does involve both an audiologist and an ENT physician. This is largely because of the challenge that's involved with performing the super deep impression and the cleaning process to make sure that everything's ready to go. That once the impression has been secured, it's sent to our headquarters in Menlo Park, California, where we do all of our manufacturing. The lens and the light tip are built to the custom specifications of the user and sent back then to the medical office, where the physician will place the lens on the eardrum in the office. No anesthesia required. It's not a surgical procedure. Really only takes about 5 minutes per ear to get that in there. And then you work with your audiologist to go through the calibration and fitting process. And from there, most of the heavy lifting is really done by the audiologist.
Right, right. So, yeah, we're used to doing a lot of heavy lifting.
Yeah.
You know? So, but no, thank you for that. You know, it's definitely a team effort,
indeed.
Right? And the better the team is that you're working with, the better your result likely with it.
Indeed.
Right?
This is really, I think of it as a truly superior level of hearing healthcare involving both the physician and the audiologist. Individual experts in their respective fields who are able to overlap and provide a really great value for the consumer of the product.
Excellent. Well, I know it's definitely exciting. It's one of the craziest innovative technologies that we've seen in a while that really has the opportunity to completely change the landscape of how we actually go about treating hearing loss.
Indeed it is.
So I'm really looking forward to seeing what you guys are doing here in the future. I'm sure that you guys are looking forward to see what else Earlens has going on. Make sure that you follow me on my YouTube channel because I'll be talking more about Earlens there. Make sure that you, if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up in the video. And I'm going to be doing some more live videos here from AAA 2018. So if you want to see some more stuff, make sure you let me know what you want to see. Drew, thank you so much for taking the time
so
with
much.
Me today.
It's my
and
pleasure.
I'll see you around.
I
okay.
Look forward to it.
Thanks.